In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. And then we read, He took the dirt of the ground and made man. He fashioned man the way He wanted man to be fashioned.
Yeah.
Earthen vessels, that's all we are.
Yes.
Earthen vessels that He can shape and mold and make however He wants to.
Amen.
Every part that He does plays a purpose in our growing.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. A lot of times, they will have an imperfection in that while it's going around the wheel because there's a little piece of grit. Maybe the clay went smooth, uh-huh. and a little old piece of grit, they'll fill it.
Yeah.
And they have to get that out and then smooth it over.
Yeah.
Can I tell you what happens, though, if they miss that little piece of sand that wasn't exactly smooth?
Mm-hmm.
When you take that vessel, when they're all through with it, they put it in the fire.
Yeah.
If it has some places that still have some little grit in it, or some air pockets, and they put it in the fire, it will explode.
Yeah.
That's what happens to every one of us when we've got these little pockets of problems in us that we don't want to work on, that we don't want to solve, that we don't want the Lord to touch, that we're willing to come up here and we're willing to pray for our neighbors, we're willing to call out the needs of our brother-in-law, we're willing to pray, God, deliver so-and-so, deliver so-and-so, but we're not willing to say, Lord, look at me.
Amen.
And then when we get put in the fire and that's in us, when hard times come and we get pushed, we get shoved, we get pressed, and the fire gets turned up hot, we can't take it.
Yeah.
Because
Amen.
We haven't dealt with those small things.
Yeah.
Church, I don't know what you're going through. It's been a year since I've been here. I see a lot of new faces. I see a few familiar faces. I really don't know what all you're going through, what you've been through, what you're yet to be through.
Amen.
What you're yet coming. I just know if you don't let the Lord shape you, you will Amen. Break down when
Come
you
on.
Get really
Amen.
In the fire.
Amen.
Churches in the United States have no idea of the fire and the persecution that's coming.
Yeah.
Right.
You're going to have some power in your life.
Amen.
Amen.
You know, that's what the Apostle Paul talks about then when he goes over to Romans and he says, Corinthians, and he says, we have this treasure in earthen vessels.
Amen.
Turn there to 2 Corinthians. I got to digress for a minute. Turn to 2 Corinthians 4:7.
Hallelujah.
We have this treasure. 2 Corinthians 4:7. We have this treasure. He's talking about the Lord of glory. He's talking about Jesus Christ, our Savior. He's talking about the power of the Holy Ghost. That's the treasure Paul is talking about.
Hallelujah.
We have this treasure in our earthen vessels.
Yes.
The same vessel I'm talking about that's going round and round the wheel.
Yes.
You know, sometimes you get tired of going round and round the wheel.
Hallelujah.
But he says in Romans, can the thing that's been made say to the potter, I don't want to be here?
Come on.
No. That's what he says in Romans chapter 9. He said, we can't say to the potter, we don't want to be here. He's making us. He says, we have this treasure in earthen vessels.
Yes.
And the reason why he chose fit to put all that power and glory in us is why? That the excellency of the power may be of God and not of us.
Amen. Amen.
He put all that treasure in us earthen vessels.
Hallelujah.
His glory.
Amen.
For Him to be revealed. And Paul says, we're troubled on every side. How many of you had trouble?
Come on.
Okay. Yet not distressed. We're perplexed. How many of you have been perplexed, confused, but not in despair? You're not without hope.
Amen.
As long as that treasure is there, you're not without hope.
Hallelujah.
Persecuted, but you're not forsaken.
Amen.
Your family may turn their back on you. I remember hearing testimony after testimony from our Native American friends, how when they turned their life totally over to God and began to testify to the one true living God, how many times their family turned their back on them because they didn't believe it that way.
Amen.
Persecuted, but not forsaken. God will not forsake you.
Amen. Come on. Hallelujah.
Cast down, but not destroyed.
Come on.
You may be pushed down. You may be stepped on, but you're not destroyed. As
Amen.
Long as you retain that treasure in your earthen vessel.
Hallelujah.
Always bearing about in the body the dying of the Lord.
Yes.
The life of Jesus might also be manifest
Come
in the
on.
Body.
Amen.
We bear these things for His glory.
Yes.
Amen.
One of my most favorite scriptures of all times is that His strength is perfected in our weakness.
Yes.
His strength is perfected in our weakness.
Our weakness.
In other words,
Amen.
It's perfected because we depend on Him when we're weak. That's when His strength
Amen.
Is revealed.
Amen.
When we lean on Him during these times, when we call upon that treasure within us,
Hallelujah.
We can go through anything.
Yes.
Amen.
When we remain with Him, when we abide in the vine and He abides in us, when our relationship with remains intact.
Hallelujah.
I can't seem to get away from that being shaped by the power of God.
Come on. Hallelujah.
I mean, all this beautiful time we had before the Lord today, that was shaping us.
Yes.
That was actually filling us.
Yes.
That was filling this vessel so we can go out and fill somebody else.
Amen.
You know, if we sit around saying we've got all of God we need and we're totally full and we don't need to come to the altar and we don't need any prayer and we don't ever have a problem that we need to come before the church with, you know, we're going to sit there and get stagnant.
Yeah.
We've got to pour out.
Yes.
I'm looking at some joyful faces today.
Uh-huh.
I rejoice so when Pastor Nick was talking about his family. That's what he said. We rejoice when they
Amen.
Rejoice. You mourn when they mourn. That's family
Amen.
Of God. That's finding together as a family of
Amen.
God. Rejoicing even when it's not your turn.
Amen.
Because when it becomes my testimony, Pastor Nate will rejoice with me.
Amen.
If I'm crying about something, Sister Christy will cry with me.
Yeah.
And when the answer comes and I'm on top, she'll rejoice with me.
Amen.
That's what it is to stay on the wheel. You know, I'm using the wheel as staying in God's hands. And His hands extended
Amen.
Is the body of Christ.
Yes.
There's
yeah.
an old
yeah.
song,
Amen.
Oh, to be His hand extended.
Amen.
Reaching out to the oppressed.
The oppressed.
Let me Amen. Touch Him.
Let me touch Him. Amen.
Let me touch Him.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh, to be His hand extended.
Yes.
Reaching, it's a song of a prayer saying, let me be God's hands extended.
Amen.
Reaching
Amen.
Out to the oppressed.
Hallelujah.
But reaching out to Him. Let me touch Him.
Amen.
Because you've got nothing to offer that one that's oppressed if you're not touching
Amen.
Jesus.
Amen.
If you don't have a relationship with Him, you don't have anything to offer.
Yes.
If Jeremiah had not been in relationship with God, he wouldn't have had the prophecy to set him straight.
Amen.
If he hadn't been in relationship
Amen.
With God.
Amen.